Good morning, everybody. I am N. Mallesh, working as an assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College. Now, I would like to start one topic, that is how English has been started from grammar topics. What is the first to end we want to know now? What is the first and what is the end? How it grammar topic like alphabets to all grammar topics? How it ended? I would like to say about you see here alphabet are 26. We have to write here alphabet. We should not write alphabets. These are 26. Okay, alphabet 26. Here 5 are vowels. Vowels are 5. And the consonants are 21. Okay. From alphabet to in sounds, according to IPA, sounds are 44. But here alphabet are 26. Next year vowels, by the combination of vowels and consonants, the next level is syllables. Syllables. The next level of vowels and consonants are syllables. What is syllable means? One vowel sound. For example, time. In time, only one syllable is there. And in the word one syllable is there. And here the word like, one syllable is there. One vowel sound. Okay. There are one vowel sound, two vowel sound, three, more than three, like polysyllables are there. For example, time is a monosyllable. And here action is a disyllable. Action is a disyllable. Okay, two syllables, disyllable. Okay. Next, alternative, and polysyllable. Examination is it? Polysyllable. Examination. Five syllables means here polysyllable. Okay. Here vowels to vowel and consonants. Next level is syllables. Syllables. Next level is words. Words. Okay, here words, by the combination of vowels and consonants, the proper combination of vowels and consonants make words, meaningful words. Okay, here words, next to place is, words are like C is a word. S-E-C is a word. So, combination of consonants and vowels make a meaningful word. Without vowels, we cannot make a word. There are rare cases, there are exemptions, like you know, your sky, the word sky is there, consonant, but your Y is a semi-vowel, it has the quality of a vowel, so we can make some words by using all consonants only, but that Y has the quality of a vowel, so this is also called a semi-vowel, sky and by, my, these are the words, with the combination of, no combination, only consonants, okay. I am saying about syllables, syllable to words, here consonants and vowels, words, next level is phrases and clauses. Yeah, what is phrase we should know? Phrase means here group of words which doesn't have a verb, which doesn't give clear meaning, no? It doesn't give meaning. So for example, here on the table, the word that on the table, here preposition, article and noun. Preposition, article and noun. No verb. Here it doesn't contain any verb. So it won't give any meaning. That's why it is called phrase. Okay. On the table and in the college, see you can know that in the college. So here this is article, preposition and noun. It doesn't have any verb. So if there is no verb, it won't give meaning. We know that verb is very important for making a sentence. So here phrase. Next, what is class also we should know? Group of words. Here is group of words, no verb. Group of words. Which should have compulsory one verb. If there is a verb, it gives some meaning. For example, like if you come here, come, C-O-M-A, come is a verb. So this verb is given. If there is verb, I said just now, you know, come is a verb, so it has some meaning. It has some meaning. This is called class. So the difference between phrases and classes are group of words, no verb, no meaning. Group of words, it compulsory it has one verb, then it will give some meaning. Okay, this is called classes. Okay, classes, in phrases there are three types like noun phrase, adjective phrase, and adverb phrase. Here, noun phrase, adjective phrase, adverb phrase means here group of words which give the meaning of noun. Here, phrase means less words, but a group of words which gives the meaning of fully about noun only. Noun meaning it will give. So that is called noun phrase. Here, adjective phrase is also same. Adjective meaning will be there. Adjective definition we will see in this noun phrase. In adjective phrase. In adverb phrase also, adverbs will say about, it describes about, it qualifies about a verb. That's why adverb meaning will be there in this adverb phrase with the group of words. These three are about phrases. Next, classes I told. In classes also, there are three type: noun class, and also you have adjective class, and adverb class. Okay, the next level of classes are sentences. Sentences. Yes, see, sentences, next level. So what I am saying here means, from starting to last grammar topic, how it is transforming and changing, moving, we are learning now. Sentences. Sentences are two types here. Type 1, type 2. We know type 2. Type 1 means here assertive sentence, and interrogative sentence. Next, imperative sentence. Next, exclamatory sentence. Okay, these are the types. One means what is assertive sentence means, which starts with declarative, also we can say this, which starts with the subject and ends with the full stop. No interrogation, no imperation, no orders, no request. So we will see in assertive sentence. It's like a statement. It's exactly like statement. Subject starts with the subject and ends with the full stop. Assertive sentence. I love my country. I is a capital letter. The subject should start with the capital letter and ends with the full stop. You are learning grammar. The letter W. It should start with a capital letter and ends with the full stop after grammar. So statement. Assertive sentences means here statement. Interrogative sentence means interrogation, questioning. There are two types like yes or no questions and WH questions. Yes or no question like are you listening properly? So this is called interrogative. Interrogative structure, how it will be? It starts with the helping verb and ends with the question mark. Like do you listen if this is a yes or no questions. We expect answers, short answers from the audience or the students or other people. Yes or no, simply. That is called interrogative. Interrogative two types. One is WH questions and another one is yes or no question. What is WH question means here? What are you doing? Where are you going? At the end, question mark compulsory there in a interrogative sentence. So assertive I said, interrogative I said, now imperative sentence. Imperative sentence, it doesn't have verb, subject. It may have indirectly, it may contain indirectly, but it doesn't start with the subject. For example, close the door, and also shut the window, come here, orders and request. You know, we'll see an imperative sentence. It starts with one verb. It starts with verb or something like please come here. Like that words we'll see in imperative sentences. Close the door, come here, request, orders we will see in imperative sentences. Next, exclamatory sentences, surprises we will see. Like it is a huge six. It is a wonderful building. Like that we'll see. So it starts with the subject and ends with the exclamatory marks. These are type 1 sentences. Now type 2 sentences means here simple sentence. One simple sentence. Two complex or compound sentence. And complex sentence. Sentence, complex sentence. See, simple sentence like here. I visited you. I visited a Jew. Subject and full stop. And also no conjunctions you are seeing in the sentence. I came here. Simple, very simple. I came here. One main class is there. So we need to know about these classes. In classes, there are main classes and subordinate class. Main class and subordinate class. Subordinate class means the part which is with if, unless, that, since, while. If you see those words in the sentence, so that is called those conjunctions. If you see that is called the subordinate class. Main class means a sentence like I came here. That is a main class. Okay. Here one main class is simple sentence. Compound sentence means two main classes. Like he is weak, so he cannot walk. So is a conjunction. The so is connecting two sentences like he is weak, he cannot walk. So here two main classes. He is weak, one main class. So is a conjunction. He cannot walk. He cannot walk is a one more main class. Two main classes we will see here. Next here complex sentence. So one main class and other subordinate class like if. See, if you work hard is a subordinate class. You will get pass. You will get pass. Is that you will pass the examination is the main class. We will see in complex sentences one main class, one subordinate class. These all are about sentences type. Next, we should know about the important part in English, that is parts of speech. Parts of speech. So what's next level? These only. But we also need to know the important one parts of speech in English grammar. That is first noun. Next to pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. These are the eight parts of speech. Noun. Noun is the name of person, place, and thing. For example, Vijay. Vijay is the name of the person. And also adverb. Adverb is the name of the place. Name of the person, place, thing. Like one dog. Dog is the name of one animal. Thing. For example, table. Table. Table is one name of the thing. Noun is a name of person, place, and thing. These are many kinds. Four, five types. Proper noun, common noun, material noun, abstract noun. Next year, this noun will involve all grammar topics. Next year, pronoun. Pronoun is a word which is used instead of noun. For example, he, see here, I, we, you, they. These are pronouns. Here, subjective pronouns. Objective pronouns also we'll see us, you, them. These are objective pronouns. Okay. In a question tag, we will it involves in a question tag. These pronouns will involve in mostly in a question tags and direct speech and indirect speech too. You should know, if you know clear about pronoun, then we can easily understand about speech, direct speech and indirect speech. Okay, next verb. Verb is very important in English grammar or any other languages. Verb expresses action, state and set of being and also position. Okay. In other topic I'll say about clearly about verb. So verb, if you want to know about tenses and voices, we should thoroughly learn about verb. Then only we can easily understand about voice and tense. Next, adverb. Adverb is a verb. Adverb is a word. It explains about verb. It describes about a verb. For example, he writes neatly. He writes neatly. Neatly is the adverb. It mostly clovered is ly means here adverb. There are some other words also like well, tomorrow, timing words also adverbs. Here, this adverb will explain about verb. Adverb will explain about verb. Okay. Adverb of types also we should know. We should learn. Next, adjective is a word. It explains about noun. Adjective is it describes about noun. It impresses Now, for example, it is a beautiful flower. This is a beautiful flower. This is a black color. I have black black pen. Black is the color. Black is describing about a pen. So adjective describes about a noun. Okay, adjectives. Adjectives mostly involve in degrees of comparison. Positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Next year adverb. Verb, adverb, adjective. See here, adverb, adjective. Next also adjective. It involves in a adjective will involve in a degrees of comparison. Next preposition. Preposition is a word. It shows the relationship between noun and pronoun. For example, it is on the table. On is a preposition. It is on the table. On is the preposition. It shows relationship between it and the table. So preposition will involve in a phrasal verbs. Verb plus verb. For example, look for. Look is verb. For is preposition. Next here conjunction. Conjunction is a word. It shows relationship. It connects the two sentences. Is weak, so he cannot walk. The word so is connects the two sentences. So conjunctions. This topic will involve in a simple. Just now I told here simple sentence, complex sentence, and compound sentence. Next here interjection. Interjection. The words are involved in a exclamatory sentences. This is a clear description about how from starting to all grammar topics. Thank you so much.